And here we go. So first round underway, and quickly you'll notice that Lubin is a southpaw. He is a natural right-hander, though, so expect to see some power with that right hand, and he's not afraid to let his hands go.
We see Lora moving around a lot, which is not typical for a Mexican fighter. But again, Lora does have a lot of experience, so I'm sure he can do what he wants. Let's see if Hammer can stop it.
And you see moving quickly, getting his jab acclimated. It just showed you the quickness right there. You just saw that quick right hook from Erickson Lubin.
Nice little stab to the body. I have a feeling that's going to be a key punch for him. Any body shots, really.
Well, Lubin just lunged in there with a straight left that caught Lora flush. And so you see both fighters studying here in the first round. I like the poise of the youngster.
Yeah, for being 19, you know, his maturity is beyond his years.
Overhand left from Lubin, and now Lora comes back with some business of his own. It's the first time that Lubin is scheduled to go 10 rounds in his short career.
I mean, normally, when fighters that have only 11 fights.
Ooh, big left hook there to the body from Lubin. And then he catches Lora with a straight left. And Lubin thinks he's found something here.
As I say, if you look at his resume, he's fought some good fighters for being a contender. Nice overhand left caught Lora. Now a hook caught Lora. He's in trouble.
As you see, Laura's face starting to turn red. The shots from Lubin. Does a nice job. Lora's hands got caught in the ropes there for a second. Went to throw a right hand, and they got caught in between the ropes. And Lubin kept firing. Good opening work here for Erickson Luba. But don't sleep on Lora. When he gets wounded, that's when he comes alive. Ripping right hook.
That body shot is money.
From the Hammer. Lora now with a quick 1-2, trying to do some work. Straight left lands from Lubin. Nice counter there from Lora with the right hand. Comes back with another 1-2. So good measured action here early on in the first. Lubin likes to see the young fighter go into the body consistently. Straight left and a big right hand to end the first round.
Oh, good overhand left, back to the body.
Good stuff for early on for Erickson Lubin, and with a crafty veteran in Orlando Lora. All right, welcome back to Out of the PBC on Bounce, and a look now to Jason Galarza. And he is the trainer for Erickson Lubin, also Mike Lescano as well. But that was Jason Galarza who was actually talking to Lubin there in the corner. What do you think? First round from the youngster.
At first round, he's shown a lot of expert moves there for being only 19 and only 11 fights. Like I was saying, though, he's had some tough opposition for only having 11 fights.
Yeah, usually a lot of times when you see a young prospect coming up and they fought 11, 15, 20 times, you're not so sure about the names in terms of the opponents and the experience level that they've had. But this gets different.
Ooh,
as you see him land a left hook there. Lora, by the way, 31 victories. He does have 5 defeats, 3-4-1, though, in his last 8 fights. And he's been with the likes of Keith Thurman, Jamal Charlo, Julian Williams. Knockout losses to all 3 of those fighters, but he has been in with obviously
better opposition,
up and coming opposition. Let's quickly send it over to Dwayne Ballin, who's in Erickson Lubin's corner. Dwayne?
Fran, you just mentioned that Jason Galarza is training him. He was telling him a moment ago, go to the body, take your time, watch the overhand right, but be smart.
And Lubin doing just that.
Yeah, he's taking his time. He's very poised, like you said. Definitely got some veteran skills.
Came up with a nice right hook, and Lora is trying to fight his way out of the corner. Look, Lora likes to be in a phone booth, so He's going to go head to head, and that's when he's going to let his fist fly.
Oh, there it is.
Straight left from Lubin. And then Lora missed on the counter. Look at the left hand from the youngster.
Nice 1-2 to follow up that body shot.
Oh, 1-2 nice again. Erickson Lubin showing you his quickness.
Ooh,
ripping body shot from the right hand from the 19-year-old. And now Lubin concentrating on the power. And he is digging in, planting both feet and letting his fist fly.
Well, Lora doesn't look too high. He's gonna have to show the ref something. It looks like he's trying to jump in.
Lubin concentrating Austin on the body. We don't see a lot of young fighters do that.
He is very mature for his age and for his experience level as far as a professional goes. Look forward to seeing this kid in the future.
Punches up, punches up, punches up.
A couple low shots.
Good exchanges low. Lubin with a bullseye on Laura's stomach.
Three times he hit him with that left uppercut to the body. Four. Now.
Right on the belt line there. Frank Santor says it's okay. There's another one on the belt line. Oh. And there he catches Lora. And now Santor is going to call that a knockdown because he says the ropes held up Lora, and Lora disagrees. Frank Santor, the referee, immediately came in and started to count Lora. And Lora obviously didn't go down, so if the ropes hold you up,
that
can be considered a knockdown.
Because there are no standing neck counts in Florida.
Let's take a look here at the end of the second round. And you tell me, was Lora out on his feet?
Yeah, the ropes kept him up.
Well, that was a big uppercut, that's right. The ropes certainly helped him stay up.
I mean, if the corner wasn't there, he would have fell flat on his back.
No doubt. No doubt about it. Hands were flailing out. And here's a look from up top.
That was a good call by Frank Santor.
Yeah, because if the ropes, if they keep you up. Second time Lora's been down in his career. Keith Thurman, the only other fighter to drop him. He's been stopped in terms of TKOs, but in terms of being down, that's only the second time. So, third round of a scheduled 10-rounder. Lubin goes right back to the body. Lora coming back as well, but I tell you what, Lubin's punches have a lot more sting on them than Lora's.
I mean, you can see the sweat fly. You can see the grimace on his face. And nice hook that he just caught Lora with.
Lora comes back with a right hand of his own and tries to deliver uppercuts. Nice short left hook there from Lora. Good uppercut as well, but Lubin right now seems to be walking through Lora's offerings.
Nice little combination from Lora. Went up and down to the body and head. Nice body shot from Lora. Ooh, good hook from Lubin. Lubin is crisp. When he wants to throw fast, he can throw fast. He does mix up power and speed very well.
Another good uppercut lands flush from Erickson, the hammer, Lubin. Lubin, a student of the game, no doubt, said, look, when he was growing up and watching boxing, he didn't have any of the premium cable channels, so he used to go to YouTube, you know, and he'd dig up all the old fights, so he definitely said he was an Oscar De La Hoya fan. Obviously, Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah.
But he said he's not only a fan of the game, he's a student of the game because he likes to learn from the styles of fighters from the past.
You know, a good thing about this PBC thing is you don't have to have the premier channels anymore. No more looking up on YouTube. You can watch them live.
There you go. You can see why many people thought that Lubin was going to be the best chance for American Olympic gold. And Lora comes back nice there with a 1-2 that connects upstairs to the head of Lubin. And now Lora thinks potentially that he's wobbled Lubin.
He's definitely having a much better round this round. Not getting totally dominated by Lubin.
Oh, ripping body shot, but Lubin, Lora comes right back. But you can see why many thought that, Lubin is going to be a great shot for the U.S. here at the Olympics. But he made the determination, because now there's no longer going to be headgear used, that if he got hurt in a fight as an amateur, it could delay the start of his career, and so decided to turn pro. And now, before we even get to the Olympics, Lubin is hoping he has a chance to be potentially fight for a title.
Right.
So far, so good. 11-0 with 8 knockouts, getting some good work in tonight against Orlando Lora. All right, welcome back now to Premier Boxing Champions, the next round, as we take a peek inside the blue corner. That's Jason Velarde talking to Erickson.
Don't forget to go up. All right,
you can do this, baby. Let's go. Nice and right.
Lubin so far in his young career, Austin. Kid's only lost 3 rounds. Kid's fought 35 rounds.
Kid's a winner.
And he's used to his fights being short. He averaged just over 3 rounds.
And again,
the fourth round here.
Like you said, this is his first 10-round scheduled fight. So he's young in the game, but he's not green. He knows what he's doing.
A look now at our unofficial scoring brought to you by Milky Way. Get lost in the chocolate, caramel, and nougat. It's from our PBC boxing historian, Jake Donovan. And he has a Lubin on top, a 30-26. Gave the extra point for the knockdown there in the second. Two big left hands from Lubin, and Lora comes right back. When he's wounded, that's when he fights his best. Does Orlando Lora.
Tiger's most dangerous when it's dying. I learned that line from Rocky.
Continue to be impressed with Lubin's discipline to stay downstairs. And those are the kinds of power shots, Austin, that don't show up in the later round.
Absolutely. If it makes it there, it's going to pay off.
Don't go through that. Don't go near there. Frank Santor. Warning Lubin there. Whoa, straight left that goes right through, and Lora says, bring it.
And a nice left uppercut as Lora tried to walk in. Good body shot.
All 8 of Lubin's KOs early in his career have come from 3 rounds or fewer. So if he's going to take care of Lora right now, right here, it's going to happen after the 3rd round. Another big uppercut. Tell you what, give Lora credit, by the way, for dealing with all this punishment and staying on his feet.
And fighting back. He's not just trying to survive, he's here to win.
Quick. Scraping left hook.
Oh, good.
4 punch combination from Erickson Lubin, and then Lora.
I don't know what's keeping Lora up.
Lubin doubling up on the jab, then going to his right hand. All the skills of this young fighter on display early on. 2 shot, solid shots around the belt line. 1 from Lora, 1 from Lubin. 4 rounds in the books. I'll tell you what, the hammer definitely so far putting on a show. This kid's a real deal, Austin.
Hey, look at this straight left. Pushed him back, and as Orlando tried to come forward, he met him with a beautiful left uppercut. Boom, nice right uppercut. You know, he just really dominated that whole round. The round for last, Lora was coming on, but Lubin took it right back his way.
You saw some blood coming from the face here of Orlando Lora, so we'll keep our eyes on that. Also from Lubin, from his lower lip. So those are 2 aspects here to keep our eyes on here. Round 5 of the scheduled 10-rounder. It's a
super welterweight bout here between Erickson Lubin and Orlando Lora, and Lubin trying to measure up Lora there for nice the left hand.
It's set up by a
big left hook there over the top, and now Lubin getting loose early. Big power shots here from Erickson Lubin.
Smart shots too, though. He's not wasting any punches. He's picking and placing them perfectly.
Straight ahead as well. Not a lot of wide activity. Direct and to the point.
Saw the good footwork there to deliver a solid left to the body.
Lubin has been at this since he was 5 years old. Before that, he was big into karate, but he followed in the footsteps of his brother, Michael Jean-Louis. And his brother actually put together a short pro career at 10 fights, 11 fights, 10 and 1 with 9 knockouts. Decided to let things go.
Uppercut. And he comes with the overhand.
Another reason he said he had to get out of karate because his sister, Marley, she was in there as well. She was giving him a tough time. She's a big-time dancer now in Canada. So there's a lot of talent in that family.
His professional family.
Good work here. Give Laura credit. He is still standing.
And he's still punching.
Well, and he knows, too. Look. We talked to him in the meetings yesterday. Did he feel disrespected here? Asked to come in after you have 31 victories. Asked to come in and fight a kid who has just 11 fights. He said, well, you know, look, kid's up and coming. He's talented. But more importantly, he kind of knows after losses to Thurman, Charlo, and Williams, he knows, look, kind of now or never. 3-4-1 in his last 8 fights.
Lubin's left. Lubin is on.
See the length there from Lubin to straight left.
Nice 3-punch combination.
Yeah, when Lubin throws, it's rarely one punch at a time. Sets it up perfectly and delivers a straight left. You're usually getting 2, 3, 4, 5-punch combinations. Oh,
beautiful bolo shot. He's in his groove now.
Erickson Lubin is starting to feel it a little bit, letting his hands go. And Orlando Lora trying to hang up. But still to come, we got the main event. We got Jamal James putting his undefeated mark on the line, 17-0 with 9 knockouts. He will go up against Juan Carlos Abreu. Abreu, 18 victories, 17 coming via the knockout. And Abreu says he has bad intentions tonight against James. So we'll shall see how that unfolds. Main event still on the way. 5 rounds in the books here. Mm-hmm. All right, now Frank Santor checking in there with Orlando, asking if he's okay.
Te doy la oportunidad, te estoy dando oportunidad, okay? Al aire. Creo que se me motive. Creo que saques golpes de poder. Estás en corto, manéjamelo. Manéjame los ganchos con las dos manos. Ok, de abajo hacia arriba, pero te quiero sólido, muy sólido. Saque el coraje. Pues vamos a rifar este round, mijo. Te quedas enfrente de él, manejando cintura siempre, ¿ok, Orlando? Hay que tener iniciativa, mijo.
Vámonos. Vámonos, mijo, vámonos.
Motiva ese round, Orlando.
So here we go here, round 6 of a 10-round scheduled fight here between Lubin and Lora. Now, let's quickly get a report here from Fernando Guerrero. Fernando, tell us what they were telling Lora in the corner.
They were telling Lora that he really need to focus on the body. You know, he's going to get tired, and his will is going to prevail. That's what they're telling Lora.
Fernando Guerrero with us tonight on Premier Boxing Champions, the next round on Bounce TV. And we're happy to have him as part of our broadcast team. And we're happy to have Erickson Lubin on as well.
Absolutely. This is definitely the next round of boxing. And it's staying true to the name. This guy's got a bright future.
What kind of pressure do you think he feels, Austin, because he makes his home here in Orlando? Obviously, you heard the cheers
You know, the pressure is on. You always want to look good in front of the home crowd. But from what I see and how his demeanor is, the crowd doesn't affect him one bit. He's just tactically, methodically breaking Lora down. He's not getting over anxious. He's not getting over rambunctious. He's just doing what he wants to do. He's doing it smartly.
Lora, with his back up against the ropes, comes out firing. And Lora doubles up there on the right hand. Leans against the rope for a little leverage. But Lubin says, hey, I'll take you bouncing back my way. And then catches Lora with a right hand. And now Lubin letting his hands go. Frank Santor taking a close look. And Lubin is close to putting Lora on the canvas. And Santor jumps in. And he stops it. It's over. Erickson the hammer and Lubin. Unloads in front of the hometown fans.
Forces the corner to step in to stop it. Good show.
Well, you know Orlando Lora, he wasn't going to quit.
No,
so he was going to keep coming, no doubt.
That's when your team has to step in and protect you because, you know, us fighters are too tough for our own good.
Lora is a crafty veteran, been around for a long time, 34 years of age. He certainly wasn't going to lay down. But I tell you what, that's an impressive performance here from the 19-year-old hammer for Orlando, Florida. Erickson Lubin picks up his 12th victory, and 9 of them have come via the knockout.
Well, that's a beautiful record he's got there, 12-0, 9 KOs. And again, they're tough opponents that he's beating up.
Poise, Austin, precision, and speed.
Yeah, it's a deadly combination. As you see, the corner had to jump in to stop it. Body shot, I think, froze Orlando Lora up and allowed Lubin to really just tee off on top.
Because at that point, Lora was no longer throwing back. That's one of the, even look at the smile
look
on Lora's face right there. He still wanted to continue, but I think the stoppage definitely was right. Oh, look now at Jason Galarza has to be proud of his prodigy. Erickson Lubin will come back with the official particulars after the break. A successful night here tonight at Full Sail Live for the 19-year-old youngster, Erickson Lubin, handing Orlando Lora just the 5th career KO loss. But I tell you what, Lubin, his father didn't want him to fight at first, but now he's fully on board. Also says, you know, he learned a lot sparring with Lamont Peterson.
Absolutely.
And basically Peterson had taught him, and you know what? You got to deal with somebody who's going to fight when they want to fight.
Right.
It's not all going to work on your timetable. So nicely done by Lubin. Time now for the final decision brought to you by the United States Air Force. Experience more at airforce.com. Here's ring announcer Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, a referee in charge, Frank Santor, waves off the bout. 1 minute, 58 seconds of the 6th round for your winner by technical knockout and still undefeated, Erickson Hammer Lubin.
Seconds into the 6th round, and Erickson Lubin made it academic, and he's standing by with Dwayne Bowe. Dwayne?
Well, Erickson, you gave the home folks just what they came here for.
Most definitely. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to come out here and make a statement for my hometown, Orlando, Florida. We all here.
Now, you seem a bit winded, wondering, because most of your fights don't go this distance. This is your first scheduled 10-rounder and your first knockout after the 3rd round.
Yeah, well, I told myself I was going to run from him. You know, he's a Mexican, and I felt like I could hurt him with some big shots if I put them together and stay right in front of him and just turn him, and that's what I did.
One thing you did for a fighter your age is go to the body more. I heard your trainers telling you, go to the body, step right into him, stay smart. You did that throughout the fight.
Yeah, well, I just felt like I landed every time I went to the body, and I seen him, like, you know, grunt every time I touched the solar plex and his stomach, and then I just knew that if I put them together and come to the head more, I could get him out of there, and that's what I did.
Because your fights have gone so quickly in the third round, most of them, were you a little surprised that you came out in the fourth and he was still standing?
No, I really wasn't surprised because I went to 8 rounds, you know, 3 different times already. I just knew that I had to get stronger as the rounds go by.
You told us yesterday when we were chatting with you that I guess you made your statement here tonight.
Yes, I did. Well, I just beat a guy 31 wins with 5 losses, 6 now, and I just want to keep moving up from here.
Now, we know also that you're in the music. You've got a CD, a rap CD. So what would the song be for tonight if you had a song out about it?
Mama said knock you up.
Hey.
I think you took care of that. Yes, Fran?
It's great stuff. Paying homage to the great LL Cool J. And yes, Mama said knock you out. And Erickson Lubin, he obliged, taking care of Orlando Lora.
Much more PBC in the next round on Bounce TV coming up.